Why? Lots of reasons. Fear, doubt, ignorance. I think those are the big ones. Fear. Fear. Fear of man. Fear of man. I think the Israelites of old experienced the same thing. They couldn't accept Christ. They lived in their world of religion and success. I can't accept this menial, small carpenter's son. But there were a few that couldn't deny it, like Nicodemus and Joseph of Arimathea. They said, "We know who you are, Jesus." There were a few that came at night and said, "I know who you are." And I said, let's stand up and let's give this truth to the world, to those who are afraid, to those who are ignorant. Huh?
Amen.
Yeah.
Right.
Amen. So I want you to see that the only reason why we experience hell is because you didn't take the key to the kingdom and you didn't repent and open up the door. That's all Jesus said you had to do. I'm right here. Just change the way you think. You know the word is, it's metanoia. Repent, metanoia, change your mind. You know, in Mark chapter 1, let me just give you a couple more keys before we go. In Mark chapter 1, verse 15, it says, "And saying, the time is fulfilled. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent ye and believe." Repent and believe. Another key. Change the way you think and believe, man.
That's right.
It's a key to the kingdom of heaven. Where are the gates of heaven? They're right here. Just believe.
Amen.
Take that key and open up the door and enter all the glory of God. Belief is the gate to heaven. Where is the gate to heaven? Where is the gate to heaven? It's repentance, it's belief. That's the gate to heaven. You want to get into heaven? It's not up there someday with St. Peter in front, with a book in front of him. Do you want to access heaven? You know, Ephesians 1 told you already. He says, you sit in heavenly places with Christ Jesus right here and now. Right? Thank you, brother. The kingdom of heaven. Belief is the key into the kingdom. So therefore, disbelief is the gate to heaven. But that's what Scripture says. Doesn't Scripture say believers and unbelievers, believers and unbelievers? Isn't it simple? Disbelief is the gate to hell. If you don't believe, if you're an unbeliever, where do you go?
Hell.
Unbelievers go to hell. Believers go to heaven. Well, that's scripturally sound. Just not the picture that we drew about it.
Right.
See, I drew this heaven up here, and I drew this hell down here, and I put Satan in hell with a pitchfork, and I said, that's hell. But God didn't say that. No. This is the gate to hell, and this is the gate to heaven. You will experience hell in this life if you don't believe.
That's right.
That's why I want to preach the gospel and tell people just believe what Jesus did and leave your hell and enter into a place called heaven.
Amen.
Luke 13:5 says, "I tell you, nay, except ye repent, ye shall likewise perish." That's here and now. All right. Let me end with Revelation. If you would, those of you who have Bibles, why don't you turn with me to Revelation chapter 2. And we'll read chapter 2 and verse 3. Just, I'm going to pick out one word throughout those passages. Okay. You know, I've been playing with these chapters for a while now. I wish I had my Strong's Concordance in front of me where I could just point out this one word. But in Revelation, I'm going to tell you, there are seven churches that the Lord or John wrote to in the book of Revelation. Seven churches. And at the end of each church, one of the things that John says to each of them is one word. You'll find it in verses 5 and all the way through. One word was at the end of the letter, he said, repent. Repent. To every one of the seven churches, God's people, churches, to every one of the seven churches, a fullness of the church age, he says one word, repent, repent, repent. After he says repent seven times to the churches, you know the drill, guys. In Revelation chapter 4, after you repent, it says in verse 4:1, it says, after this, after what? After you completely repent and change your mind, after this, I looked and behold, a door was opened where? In heaven. A door was opened in heaven after you change your mind. Change your mind, change your mind, change your mind. Stop telling me that you're broken. Stop telling me that you're tired. That's the seven churches of Revelation. Stop telling me about Satan. Stop telling me about Jezebel and her daughters. Stop it already. Stop binding that spirit of Jezebel. She has been bound for 2,000 years. He says, repent, 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 repent. Stop working, stop working, stop working. I know your works. Will you just repent? And if you ever repent, he says, just enter into my glory. If you would just change your mind, I'll give you the tree of life to eat from. If you would just change your mind, I'll let you be a pillar in the house of my God. If you will just change your mind, you'll realize that heaven is already inside of you. And then when the church fully comes to repentance, it says in verse 4, it says, boom, guess what's opened? The gates of heaven. You just opened the gate of heaven. And then from 4 on, you have access to the throne room. Because it says, and behold, the door was opened in heaven, and the first voice which I heard was as a trumpet. And talking with me, he said, come up hither, come up hither. That's in your understanding, come up hither. I will show you things that must happen hereafter. Verse 2, and immediately I was in the spirit, and behold, a throne was set in heaven. And one who sat on the throne. Where is that throne? It's in heaven. Where is heaven? Thank you. How do you get in there? You should get to the gates, man. Now, I just got a few things to say, and we're done now. In Revelation chapter 1, it says that there is a city called the New Jerusalem, right? In this New Jerusalem, there is a wall, and there are 12 gates that access this New Jerusalem, right? It says in my Bible, and I think it says in your Bible too, that in this New Jerusalem, you know what it says? It says the gates are always, take a guess, open or closed?
Open.
Yeah, the gates are always open. Isn't that something? The gates are always open. It says, as a matter of fact, in Revelation 22:14, it says, blessed are they that do his commandments, that they may have the right to the tree of life and may enter in through the gates into the city. Now, the 12 gates are named after the 12 tribes of Israel. So, if I want to enter into the kingdom of heaven, I have to enter into the gates. My thinking has to line up with these 12 gates. So, what are the names of the 12 tribes of Israel? What's the first son of Israel? Anybody know the first son born to Jacob? Judah's, well, he's up there. He's in high ranking. Joseph is in high ranking. Just throw out all the names for you, all right. Reuben's the first one. Okay, while we're in this mode, what are some of the other 12 of the tribes of Israel? Okay, shout out.
Levi.
Levi.
Dan.
Dan. What's your name?
Dan.
Sure, Dan. You want to be bashful? Naphtali, Asher.
Manasseh.
Very well, yes, Manasseh, Ephraim, God bless you, sons of Joseph. You know, when I read like Asher and Naphtali and Zebulun, I start to think of the reindeer, you know? I think it's Asher that triggers me. Go Asher, go Prancer. It's like, no, that's not the kingdom. But you know what Asher means? You know what Asher means? It means happy. Let me tell you something, church. Jesus died, and we're done here, but I'm going to give you a definition of these things. He died on the cross to give you the kingdom. You will access it through the gates of the kingdom. The first gate is Reuben. Reuben means a son. Behold a son. You will enter into the kingdom of heaven by knowing that you are a son of God.
Amen.
You are not a child of the devil.
That's right.
You are a son of God. Neither is anyone else in this world.
Amen.
He is the father of all creation. Right? Judah. Does anybody know what Judah means? Praise. You will access heaven here and now by putting a little praise in your understanding and a little praise in your mouth. All right. Yeah, you guys are partially in. You're 212 sin. Levi. Levi means, that's a hard one. I had to look it up. Levi means join. You're just joined to him. It's just that simple. You realize you're one with God. Joseph. Do you know what Joseph means? Joseph means that he will add too. So Joseph had another son, or Joseph had a brother named Benjamin. But anyway, Joseph was replaced by his two sons. They were Manasseh, which means he forgets all my sorrow, or I forget all my sorrow. Another son, Ephraim, which means this is called the king.